Hey guys, Carlo here. Welcome to the vlog. This is the channel where we talk about sneakers, life, and tech. And for today's episode, I want to compare the Nike Zoom X Invincible, which is a sneaker that I unboxed recently. And I mentioned in the title that it could be one of the most comfortable Nike sneakers to date. And I want to compare it with the Adidas Ultra Boost 21. It's going to be a fun video. Keep on watching. Let's go. By the way, if you guys haven't subscribed yet, now is the best time because we have two ongoing giveaways. One is for an electronic unicycle that's being raffled in this channel. So make sure that you click the link down below to see the mechanics. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to comment down below what you guys think of the sneakers I'm about to show you. The second giveaway is for a brand new watch. Check out my watch channel. I will link the video down below. I'm also doing a giveaway there. Good luck to all of you. Now, I need to give you guys context before we get to the review. I have wide and flat feet. That is not usual. I think a lot of people have narrow or normal size feet. I have wide feet. I have flat feet. And that has a big impact on what I am about to say in today's episode. So this is the Nike Zoom X Invincible. And when I mentioned in my earlier unboxing that it was super hella comfy, I wasn't able to put in like a significant amount of steps yet. However, as of today, I probably put in over, 30, 40,000 steps. Take note, this is a casual review, okay? If you want running reviews, I will link down below to performance runners who review sneakers professionally for running. This is an everyday casual review. So for this particular shoe, I have some serious issues. My first major issue is that I constantly felt like I needed to balance myself when I was standing still. Again, that is a product of me having flat feet. There is no arch support, so the super soft cushioning tends for me to roll my ankles inward. So because of that condition, when I stand still, I feel like I'm on a hoverboard or something wherein I have to constantly balance myself so I don't fall. So that is super annoying. However, when I'm walking, it just feels so good. I love the foam. It's super soft. It definitely cradles your feet in an amazing way. It's like walking on clouds or marshmallows and stuff like that. So when it comes to softness, it's a win. When it comes to stability, specifically for me, a guy with flat and wide feet, this is a big L. And it sucks. It totally sucks because I really want to love this shoe. I really want to like this shoe. But unfortunately, after trying it out, after using it for a couple of days, after breaking it in, I can honestly tell you that this is not for me. Which brings me to the next shoe. Of course, we have over here the venerable, the legendary Adidas Ultra Boost. And you're probably thinking, wow, Carlo, being the Adidas fanboy that he is, will rain showers of praises on the Adidas Ultra Boost 21. Unfortunately, again, wide, flat feet. The flat feet is a deal breaker, yo, guys. I mean, the massive cushioning that you get here with the thick boost is great for people with normal feet, with normal arcs. But again, for me, it's the same experience. I mean, there is that issue with stability. There is that issue with support. I can probably get like a custom insole to fix that issue. That's actually what I'm thinking today. Maybe I can buy like a custom insole so I can still rock my 21, Ultra Boost 21, or the Nike Zoom X, since I already, you know, put down money for both of them. But yeah, but if I were to pick between the Ultra Boost and the Invincible X, this one scores higher in the stability. It scores higher in the support. I don't feel like I need to balance myself all the time with the shoe. Feels more natural. But the other one is just so much more mushier, so much more softer. The feeling, the experience is different. This one is firmer. So probably that's the reason why I don't have as much support stability issues with this. But if you just want like super soft shoes to lounge around like a coffee shop or like a, I don't know, like a work from coffee shop or restaurant type of setup, I think that one fits the bill. if you want something that you will walk in for a significant amount of time, at least for me, the 21 does a better job. So there you have it. Now, if you want to buy any of these two sneakers, I will link them down below to where you can buy them on the Nike Philippines website and the Adidas Philippines website. Now, if you're wondering what I feel is like the most comfortable sneaker for a guy like me who has wide and flat feet, you know what? I will keep on going back to my New Balances, be it the 990s, V3, V4, V5. I have a bunch of them over here, as you can see, in different colors, from the grays to the purples to the, yeah, even have like a pink New Balance 990. So that's how much I love that shoe. Again, it's just a great fit for the type of feet that I have. And apart from the New Balance, I also like this shoe, which is the Nike React Infinity Run 2. This is the second generation version. I did an unboxing of this. If you haven't seen it yet, I will link it down below. This is also a really good shoe, perfect for people who are like me, who have wide and flat feet. For those who have wide feet though, I would recommend that you loosen up the laces, because there is a tendency for the midfoot section, as you can see over here, to be a little bit narrow. Now, at this point in the vlog, I'll be bringing you guys along with me. I will be picking up an item from one of my favorite stores. Alam niyo na yan, Off-White Manila. So they have a really nice accessory that I saw on their Instagram, and I will be picking it up, and I'll be bringing you guys along with me. So tara, let's go. Dusty, say hi to the vlog. Say hi to the vlog, Dusty. Guys, we have Dusty merch coming soon. The Dusty shirt is dropping in March, on March. So watch out for it. March, Dusty merch, Project 721. The shirt is friggin' dope and awesome. Watch out for it. Let's go. So we're on our way to Off-White Julius, and it's a Julius, so, diba? So I just want to give you, get your thoughts on something, guys. So I was talking to a good friend of mine who's a nurse, and he was planning on going to the UK, and I asked him what he felt about yung news of the Philippine government offering nurses in exchange for vaccines, and he said that he kinda understood why the government did it, but it doesn't erase the fact that it made him feel a little bit bad, because parang so ganun na lang, para kaming chicken or para kaming pork for trade pang X deal. So I really felt bad for him. So what do you guys think of the situation? Let me know in the comment section how you think that particular deal or barter went down. Obviously, the UK turned it, the UK and Germany turned the proposal down, I think, deploying like hundreds of thousands of nurses in exchange for vaccines. But yeah, gusto ko lang kwento sa inyo kasi I just saw another article on my phone while we were on our way to Off-White. So, yun lang. Okay, so we out! Face shield nga pala. So we're here at our favorite store in the Philippines. Oh, di ba? Talaga favorite store, Off-White Manila. And ang makikita natin is the accessory that I mentioned to you guys earlier na sobrang gusto ko makuha. And of course, nandito ang walang kamatayang napakagwapo. Sundan nyo siya sa Instagram. I will link that. Baka mas scandal. I'll link down below to his IG. So bro, ano ba yan nandyan? Yung napakagandang release okay. Na yan.
So what we have here will be a collaboration with Bron. So it's a collaboration with Off-White. As you can see, it is an alarm clock, no? What's nice about this is very aesthetic siya at home.
Yeah, very minimalist, no?
Yes. So here.
Nice. Magkano benta sa kanya?
This one is 3,998.
Nice.
Yes.
So if you guys are looking for, okay siya pang regalo, no?
Actually, there's so, a lot of people na
yun
yung get this plano. For a gift. It's a very special piece and limited also.
Ah, so if you guys want one, it's still available here in Off-White Manila. A little over 3,900 pesos. Siyempre, kukuha tayo. Kung gusto nyo ng isa, comment kayo sa baba. Malay nyo, magparaffle tayo. Woo! By the way, if ever you find yourself here in Off-White Manila, and size nyo to, this is size 40 UK. Ano yun sa US? Size 7. For me, this is one of the very best Off-White sneakers that have come out recently. 29,398. Sobrang guapo. Sobrang ganda. Sobrang suave. In fact, you know, that's what I'm wearing right now. So you can actually get this last pair here at Off-White Manila. So 1, 2, 3, 4. May isa pa. So we're buying 5 of the Off-White Bron clocks. And it will be heading over to a few special people that we have for the businesses that I run. O, diba? Gaganda. Magandang pang regalo. Okay, so that's it for today's episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe to Julius. Panoodin yun na rin yung mga videos niya. And that said, this is Carlo. Boom, sign out. Peace, God bless. What's up? Boom.